Hola, mis amigos, ¿cómo están? Welcome back to the channel. So as you probably must already know, Mexico released their roster for the final round of the World Cup qualifying games, which includes the next big game, the huge game against US men's national team. I've got the list up here. You can probably see in the reflection of my glasses. So we're just gonna go through and I'm gonna give my opinions on each player as we go along. For me, generally, as an introduction, I think it's two steps in the right direction. The downside is not all of it is because Martino's in the light. I think injuries have forced him to make some of these changes. But they are good changes, and hopefully, these new players play well, and he suddenly goes, oh, maybe I should have been playing them all along. And then the final introduction thing I want to talk about is four keepers again. Like, you've got three games. So even if you rotate each goalkeeper for each game, one goalkeeper is not going to play. Arguably, two goalkeepers are not going to play. So, what's the point in having four? For me, the only reason you'd have four goalkeepers is if you don't have enough outfield players and you need a spot to fill. It's so annoying. I don't know why he's done it. Obviously, a player could get injured, blah blah blah, but three is enough. For three games, three goalkeepers is enough. So going into them with Rodolfo Cota, Ochoa, obviously, Orozco and Talavera. Obviously the glaring problem with that would be Orozco. I mean, I personally love Orozco. I think he's one of my favourite goalkeepers. I would hands down have him at Chivas if we sold Gudino to Europe. Jimenez is doing all right, but I don't know, I've never been totally enamored by Jimenez. But I'd have Orozco at Chivas for a couple of years, hell yeah, for sure. But he probably not good enough, he's definitely not good enough for the national team, if I'm being blunt. Although definitely more than good enough to play for Chivas in my opinion. Cotter as well. I mean, is he really gonna play? I mean, he's doing all right for Leon, even though they just lost their CONCACAF Champions League game. But he's doing all right. He's an all right goalkeeper, but being an all right Liga MX goalkeeper is only so far. All these goalkeepers as well, I think between 35 and 39 years old. So, and then you've got Talavera, who is a decent backup. He's a decent backup. For me. It should have been, I'm pretty sure 99% of Mexico fans would agree that it should be Ochoa, Talavera, and Acevedo. God knows why Acevedo is not being called up. He's young, he's brilliant already. Like, in him in five or six, him in three, imagine, I think he's 25, so imagine him in 3 years' time. He's going to be absolutely badass. Get him in the setup, man. Just get him in there, get him learning from Ochoa. Unfathomable. Nobody can understand why Acevedo is not in this team. He needs to be in the team. Hell, play him in the game. I would be totally happy seeing Acevedo playing for Mexico over Ochoa, who still performs all right for Mexico, but he's had a bit of a up and down time with America since he's been there. But that's the goalkeeper. I don't want to write too much on about each particular position, but the goalkeeper for me, the goalkeeper position is the glaring issue, and there's two of them. The fact that there's four of them, and the fact that Acevedo is not called. If Acevedo was one of the four, I wouldn't be as pissed off as I am, to be honest. It is what it is. Blatantly, Ochoa is going to be playing most of the three games. Don't know why we've got four. Anyway, going into the defenders, Angulo from Tigres, Aguirre. Eric Aguirre, that's pretty good. Pretty happy with him. Julian Araujo, Mexico's starting right back for the next 6 or 7 years. Brilliant. Hopefully, he gets to play. Néstor Araujo, standard. Gerardo Arteaga, great. So glad that he's back in the setup. Excuse me. Again, Mexico's left back for the next 6 or 7 years. Jesus Gallardo, he's good enough for backups, but you can totally tell that if Martino looks at Arteaga and Gallardo, he's like, I'm going to pick Gallardo. It's like, mate, I don't know. Gallardo, as a backup, as somebody to take over, there's a injured Arteaga, fair enough. Or even Aguirre. I'd have Aguirre over Gallardo. I think Aguirre and Arteaga should be the two left backs. Anyway, so that's the problem I have with the defence at the moment is Gallardo. César Montes, probably the starting one of the starting centre backs. Hector Moreno, well, he's got experience. He's, you know, his experience, his age probably help him more. Some people really don't want him in the squad, but I think as a squad, he's all right. He offers the off the field mentor kind of role, whereas, you know, not quite a starting centre back role anymore. Reyes from Puebla. Puebla have had a really good season, so it's kind of understandable to see him in there. And there's Jean as well, so it's pretty good. Jesus Sanchez. Sorry, Jorge Sanchez. People hate him. I rate him. I've always liked Sanchez. Is he as good as Araujo? I think Araujo is probably already good better than him. Sanchez is brilliant. He's got very poor decision making, and he has off season, but America's been up and down. So, you know, how much of it is him rather than the club and the team? But, you know, for me, I'd rather have Jorge Sanchez and Araujo in there over Chaka, sorry, because Chaka should never be back in this Mexico team ever again. And then obviously Johan Vasquez as well. Oh, excuse me, let's see. Yeah, so Vasquez, blatantly Mexico's best centre back at the moment. And then César Montes. Yeah, César Montes. I think Montes and Araujo should be the starting centre backs, with Arteaga on the left and Araujo on the right. If they play that back four, it's inexperienced-ish. Don't get me wrong. Vasquez doesn't have that much experience with the national team, but still, I think that could be a sick back four. And if they gel and they get enough time, they've got years to kind of form a decent team. So we'll have to wait and see. So I think Gallardo is the main issue for me in the defence. But apart from that, I think it's pretty decent. Moreno again offers leadership qualities off the field. So I think that helps him stay in that team. Going to the midfield, this is a doozy. So Edson Álvarez, blatantly Mexico's best centre mid, I think he is. Uriel Antuna, blinding with Cruzeiro. Really sad to see him leave Chivas, to be honest. But you know, sometimes you have to move to find a better system, and I think the system and the coaches at Cruzeiro is better and suited to him more than Chivas was. Chivas kind of centered around Vega at the moment. So yeah, he's in there, fair enough. It's Eric Gutierrez, doing all right for PSV. Obviously, he's back starting for them now, so understandable that he's in there. Hector Herrera as well, Hacha Hacha. Brilliant for Atletico Madrid, even though they got knocked out. No, they didn't get knocked out, they went through the Champions League. Sorry, I think they've got Man City next in the next round. So that's a tough one, even for Atletico Madrid. But yeah, he's doing brilliantly, even though he's going to the MLS next season. Don't know why he's made that decision. He could have stayed in Europe, to be honest with you. But he's doing really well, so hopefully he brings that Atletico form and brings it in, because he's been a bit off with Mexico for pretty much like a year. So hopefully he brings that back into the team and helps Mexico. Diego Lainez, again, can't seem to get game for Betis, but it's Diego Lainez. Super young, super quick. Don't think he starts any of the games, but definitely come off the bench. His pace, he's rapid. He could do some real damage on you know, in the 70th minute with tired defenders. He could be really good. Then we come to the last three, beginning with Rodolfo Pizarro. I love Pizarro. You know, he's done a lot for Chivas. You know, he's a great guy, he's a great player, but he's been off for a long time, and don't really know why he keeps getting called up. He's not in this team because of merit, in my opinion. I love him to death. You know, he's done really well for Chivas, but he's not good enough to be in the Mexican national team at all. He hasn't done enough to be in the team. Very strange, out of the blue. Martino seems to like him. I think it's probably because he plays in the MLS, and we used to play in the MLS, and Martinez got a bit of a soft spot for the MLS, so inexplicable. One of those things that Martino does that nobody else can figure out. Charlie Rodriguez, obviously decent, doing really well actually again for Cruz also. Understandable, and he's youngish as well. Pretty much, I'd say the Hacha replacement, because you know his Hacha's involvement in the Mexican national team is limited now. Missing Guardado though, which sucks. I mean, I like Guardado, and I think he's been doing really well for Betis. And he's also close to breaking the all-time Mexican caps record for Mexico as well. So kind of sucks for him. I think he's injured, so fair enough. But still, a bit of a miss. People seem to like the fact that he's not in the team, but I actually rate him still. So, and then Luis Romo, who again, Monterrey and the Monterrey players just shouldn't be in this team, to be honest with you. But it is what it is. Romo has fallen way off. He at one point he was a really, really good midfielder. He's fallen off big time. Sucks, but it is what it is. Don't know quite why he's playing. I think his rotation. I think Herrera, Edson Alvarez, and Charlie Rodriguez should start, or maybe Gutierrez, Alvarez, and Hacha might be the starting three centre mids for the USA game. Can't get my words out at the moment. And then going into the forwards, Tecatito Corona found new lease of life in Sevilla. Absolutely buzzing for that move. Seems to be doing really well there. Sevilla got, I think they got knocked out by West Ham in the Europa League, but still domestically doing all right. And he's doing all right with them. He's getting game time, which is the main thing. I think hopefully that carries on into the national team, and he does quite well. I think he starts alongside Lozano, who's pulled up. He's doing really well at the moment. Got over his little injury from the last bout. Gets injured every time he plays for Mexico at the moment, so hopefully he doesn't get injured this time. And then Raul Jimenez, I think those are the front three that start. And then you've got Alexis Vega, who now has cemented his position in the national team. He could start, maybe. He might start, actually, instead of Tecatito. Brilliant. My favourite player out of all, out of Arsenal or Chivas. I think he's my favourite player for sure. If Arsenal buy Alexis Vega, my head will explode. And I'll video it to prove it. So guaranteed that he's going to be in there, which is great. Henry Martin, as a backup striker, okay, I guess. And then Santi Jimenez, which is a massive addition. He's doing really well. All these Cruz Azul players deserve to be in this team. They're doing really well at the moment. Hopefully, get some game time. Hopefully, I mean, I think Jimenez starts most of these games. Hopefully, Jimenez comes off the bench, and Santi Jimenez, should I say, comes off the bench and does quite well for Mexico. I think he's one of the future strikers that we're going to depend on once Jimenez and Henry Martin and Funes Mori. Funes Mori, I don't think, should ever be in the national team again. I think the Funes Mori experiment has failed, and it's proven that it's failed, and he shouldn't be back. I think Henry Martin's time should be severely limited from now on. Jimenez, maybe Macias, if he picks up some decent form for Chivas. Maybe Vega up front for a striker. Maybe he might do well for Mexico. But that's the team. Again, I like it. I mean, the only difference I think was Alan Mozo. Alan Mozo should be playing. He's blindingly brilliant, probably the best right back in the Liga MX at the moment. Inexplicable why he's not in the team. But if Julian Araujo starts most of these games and plays, I won't be that mad, to be honest with you. I want to see Julian Araujo play. I think he's got top ceiling. And Moses doing brilliantly at the moment, but Moses is older, a lot older than Araujo. So, like I said, without Xhaka in there, hopefully it is Araujo that plays, starts anyway. If he plays and plays a lot, then yeah, I'm not gonna be that mad about Mozo, but Mozo should definitely be in there in the squad. I don't know why he's not. Other than that, it's a step in the right direction. No Funes Mori, no Xhaka, no Domingos, I think his name is. There's a load of players that were in the last one that are not in this one, and it's great. Funes Mori, I think, is only out because he's injured. But yeah, I like this team. I'll give it an 8 out of 10. If Mozo and Acevedo, even Chicharito. If take away take out Henry Martin, put Chicharito in, put Alamoza in, and then bring Acevedo in for Araujo or Cota. That's a 10 out of 10 for me. This is a 10 out of 10 squad, but this is what it is. We do play USA in like a week or so, a few days, so we'll have to wait and see how this team does. Let me know in the comments what you thought of the team. Who do you think that I haven't mentioned should be in it but aren't? And who do you think who do you think shouldn't be in the squad that is and that I might not have mentioned? Maybe you don't agree with Jimenez, Raul Jimenez being in the team, or Ochoa even. Let me know in the comments. We'll have a conversation about it in the comments. But yeah, take it easy, guys, and I'll see you guys for. I'll do a review video for every single game that they play in the qualifiers, and then maybe a video if we qualify or not. So yeah, take it easy, guys. I'll see you guys next week for the USA game, and I'll see you guys then. Take care. Adios.